Hi there everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Pillars of Eternity. Today we are hopefully gonna finish Durgan's battery. Previous episode we entered, we respect characters, we entered, we cleared the first floor and then we came down, we went to the upstairs, where we are now. Took a little, I don't know what it is, a little. Run, motherfucker, run! So nice to have frames again. Holy shit. Continue past the moments.
Keeping an eye out.
Come to think of it, I think the monk must be in front.
We can't hold him off! Fall back!
Hello? She's hitting me. Just straight up kick ass.
What?
Where is Priesty?
Looks like it hurt.
And I'm stuck.
That's not very helpful.
I like this twin arrows for everything.
That looks like it hurt. Hey there.
Not a sound. Nice and quiet.
If it makes you rest easier.
I shall do my best. Done.
Yeah?
Thank you.
Don't look back!
Keep running!
Is this correct? I don't want to go the correct way.
Zabo will see it. I shall do my best.
You're useless.
Losing ground! They're coming over the barricade!
What could have broken through this?
That looks like it hurt. Sure.
Exceptional, oh, it's a morning star. And exceptional. Ooh.
Hey there.
Gears. They're coming!
Looks like it hurt.
I can take the transport away from something.
Sure.
A hopeless battle was waged in Durgan's battery. They seemed to know that their deaths had come, yet many fought on.
All the good it did them. They seemed to know that their deaths had come, yet many fought on.
Their bravery was not enough in the end. They might have made great Nalpazka warriors, if only they had been born to Khan.
Hey there.
They gave a fuck at the Khan.
Laying low.
Hey there.
Shitty boots on. I'm trying. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I hope there's a key to get into that place.
We're outnumbered!
Hear that?
It is the most letter. Something was hastily scrolling across the space. It reads, Floru, we're trapped here, but I take heart in knowing you're safe below. When this ends, take whatever you can carry and leave the forward bone picker at once. Take your nephew if you can. It's not safe here. Keep this with you. Your love, always more. The other side looks like a poem, but it's obscured with dirt.
Safe here.
Quiet.
Hurry, we can hide here.
They're going to come for us here and
remains lie on the floor covered in dirt and swathed in cobwebs, essence drifting nearby, hanging in the stale air like dust knots. It takes a little additional effort, but you manage to gather a floating essence to you. Your work You work your way into this, into it, and suddenly find yourself immersed in the soul's memory. The shock hits you with an utmost physical force. Your heart hammers within your chest. Other Pekunen rush past you, retreating or attacking. It's gotten hard to tell. You're running along the dark path, dark tunnel, pushing your overtaxed body as fast as it will go. Your heart pounds harder with each step. Concussive thumps echo above you. Each one seems to resound in your heaving chest. You pass the mines and reach the main hall. It's packed full of shouting, shoving, panicking dwarves. Even if you could reach the door at the other end of the without getting trampled or beaten to death first, something in the fever of the crowd tells you it's already locked. The tunnel behind you rings with screams. You add another dial for the door to the forge below, but it's locked in the workshop on the other side of the barricade. The sounds of battle grow closer. You race to go to the mines, ignoring the building pressure in your chest. You scurry deeper into the mines, losing track of your path. The tunnel seems to close around you. You stumble and fall. You try to pull yourself up, but your arm is dull with pain. Even though you've stopped, you can't quite catch your breath. For the first time, you notice a squeezing agony in your chest. Darkness gathers around. That's why a key glance and next to the corpse. As you do, screams of horror and fury, the dead of Durgan's rat recovery converge on you. This is tough. What a shame. Wait, let's finish this first.
Stop them!
Just fucking say so then.
Whoa.
What are you doing up here?
Sure.
Fuck, the ice drawers and stuff get stuck in here. It was locked.
That's how it's done.
Ah, thank God that rock!
Keeping an eye out.
Three might for 20 seconds per kill, 5 damage reduction. Cover visage plus 20 seconds per kill.
Whoa.
I need me some of that.
What's this?
Hey there.
Come, come. Can I hear that?
That's it!
That looks like it hurt.
Be on the seat.
That looks like it hurt.
That was actually cool. Again.
Avaru, be on seat.
Zabo will see it done.
Blasphemy!
Amazing trump, exceptional accuracy. Of course, blind on hit or critical hit or bypass. Just found you a waveform. Right low. Where are you? Caused by an affliction. Okay.
Sure.
Really down.
Ow.
Mm-hmm.
And the fire shows me something new.
I have done as you asked. Done.
Circular depression called is a stone that's below the relief of a dwarven warrior. The armor-clad figure stands at guard against the unseen enemy. Inspect the carving. The whole bunch at the bottom of the circular depression, these edges seem worn as if something had scraped against them. Above the depression, a dwarf appears ready to defend against charging, holding a shield high and a sword low. You hold the symbol in place gently, matching his protrusion against the holes in the circular depression. No matter how much you try, they do not appear to fit together. What about the helm? Inspect the stone. Okay, so it's a short song. Inspect the calling. No dwarves appear to be ready, just holding a shield below and so on. Now the symbol. Okay, symbol of the sword is on. So I'm still shooting another symbol.
You profane Abigon's sacred crown.
Well, shit. Is it loading so long?
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Yeah?
These are...
Laying low.
Stupid bitch.
I have done as you asked.
This is too bad.
You profane Abidon's sacred ground.
Sure.
Let us in. They're coming.
As you approach the door, you notice around the depression within the surrounding frame. The molding around the depression is elaborately carved with a row of four and symbols lining up to the topmost edge of the circle. Places the disc on top. Okay, at first the disc does not seem to fit until it is oriented specifically where you hear a quiet click and the casing it sinks into place. Nothing appears to happen right away, however, on the disc itself, an arrow shaped protrusion points north. The dial rotates easily enough, so the particular strategy behind the wall. The dial comes to a rest with a faint click. The arrow points. The dial spins out of hand, it makes a complete revolution and rises in a rush. Rest the disc with an arrow point, you feel a satisfying thunk and notice that the dial has sunk a fraction of an inch into the depression. This door is still locked, but this feels like a step. Okay. Let's go back one and push. Okay. So it's down, left, right. Down the fire up. No. but there must be somewhere that I missed. I don't have the final disc. Is he dying now? So we end up here if we use the stairs. Call it and do that to Pudgy.
Thank you.
I want to download the together speed on the next rise. It becomes clear that there is some form of enchantment upon the track. The card loses none of its momentum. You find yourself rapidly approaching a fork in the tracks. One track leads later to another. Upward. To the right. Look around quickly. You know, there's another lever alongside the tracks, the mine copperals. Grab the lever as you pass. We'll grab the lever. Do it yourself. You hang over the side of the cart, reaching for the lever, and nearly topple head over heels onto the track. You quickly pull back into the cart, and the lever moves away out of sight. Then a year and there as it follows a tunnel. Basket remains of ore, an occasional piece of abandoned mining equipment. As the mining begins to start, you should pressure again and realize that you can't get back to where you started. Anyway, that's going to be it for today, guys. That was the mines of Durgan's battery. Before we end, to level up, but maybe he can get good in mechanics. Venom Strike. Dangerous implement. I can't have so many modals. Vulnerable attack, modal, faster runner, deep pockets, arms bearer, weapons, preserve, disruptor, manage recovery, section of damage reduction button. Okay. He needs it. Okay, so this is gonna be it, guys. Hopefully in the next episode. Hopefully this is the last level. The Foundry, yes, looks like it's gonna be the last level. Then we're gonna move on to the White Marsh part 2. So I'll see you guys in the next episode. Have a fantastic day.